So we're still here at Prismic Studio with Sebastian Chopin, and now we are going to talk about what's new, what you're working on, what are you working on in Nuxt nowadays?
So right now, when I'm talking, we are at Nuxt v2.6, and we have some minors version coming before the 3.0. What's coming will be without breaking changes. So it will be the Nuxt CLI, where you will be able to add modules, remove modules from the CLI. You will be able to install this CLI globally. We will open more the modules to be able to export commands. So you will be able to use them with the CLI. As well, we will open more the testing to give best practice for testing. We are lacking a bit on this part. And you will have the Nuxt test command as well.
So can you explain how the... as of today, how test goes for Nuxt?
So for testing, you use we use Puppeteer or Cypress for the end-to-end testing, and for the unit testing, we use Jest directly.
And what's lacking?
What's lacking is some utils. It's more Nuxt Test Utils. Mm-hmm. We will call them like this, so you can directly navigate inside your Nuxt app, test some async data. Access more inside the pages components that are a view component but extended. Mm-hmm. So we need to extend the view test utils to be compatible with these components.
All right.
To make your life easier to test. And next we will have the full static generation. It has been asked for 6 months now. And if you generate your website as a static website and you host it on a CDN with Nuxt Generate, you won't have to keep your API alive on production. Every pages will be cached. The payload will be saved as a JSON. So you will be able to use as an offline application directly.
Right. So basically, you generate your website and that's it. It's not going to generate anything. But what happens when you publish? You have to regenerate everything? How are you thinking about doing if you publish something new or correct a typo?
You will have to regenerate the page. So you won't have to build again your website, since if you change the JavaScript, you will have to bundle your application again. If you just change the content that comes from an API, you can regenerate the pages you want. Mm-hmm. It will be better to fully generate all of the pages, because you don't know where this data is used, if it's in the listing or a page. But the generation is pretty fast, and we are working on the workers to have multiple runner to generate the page in parallel. And lastly, we have this
kind of... So there are separate things, the static generation and workers.
Yes. So workers will improve the performance of Nuxt considerably. We will have multiple workers for the... for view server render. So every time you will hit a root, it will be one of the workers that will server render the page. Mm-hmm. It will be the same for the bundler. For Webpack, we'll be able to distribute them through different threads. And it opens many, many ways, but I don't want to spoil, and it's still pretty complex right now. One good news is for the static generation, we also have something that is really, really nice. I tested it yesterday and it's working. It's this kind of smart crawler. So when you generate your application right now, when you have dynamic routes, you have to list all of them. So Nuxt knows what routes it has to generate, or the blog post. Right now, with this new system, we will generate the homepage and we will follow all the links directly, like a Google crawler. Mm-hmm. But because it's our component, we know the routes, so we are able to fully generate your whole website without you giving the dynamic links.
Okay, so you will be able to figure out what pages to be generated without having dynamic links, if you have dynamic links.
Yeah, right. It will work for dynamic and non-dynamic links.
The same way, so you don't have to specify something special for dynamic links.
No, not anymore.
Okay, nice. Well, thank you for telling us about all these things.